In this video, I'll take you through the steps to creating a successful Mascot logo that is powerful and delivers a strong message. Brothers and sisters, how's it going? I'm very excited to have you back here with me. I'm Rupen from Jammed, and in this video, I'll be guiding you through the Mascot logo creation process, which was actually suggested by one of you guys, and I'm really passionate about this topic, so creating this video was definitely very interesting for me. And it really made me notice a lot of the hidden things about great Mascot logos, which is what I'll be sharing with you guys today. I will be walking you through the steps taken to create a visually appealing, successful Mascot logo. These steps are referencing, sketching, shading, vectorizing, and colorizing, which result in a powerful, long-lasting Mascot logo. If you're new to this channel, here we do a bunch of cool shit on Jammed, and you'll find a lot of design tips, tutorials, and talks that might give you a new perspective on design in general. If you enjoyed this video, I'm certain you'll enjoy other Jammed content as well, and I'd highly encourage you to go take a look around. Personally, I do not consider myself a pro-level Mascot logo designer, however, I've started Mascot logo design very early in my design career, around 2016-17, and I made a bunch of terrible logos that actually helped me learn how to design decent logos, which is how any learning process is in most of the creative field, I believe. You start out extremely terrible, and over time you start to create things that actually look decent over time, because your eyes typically adjust to filter out the good from the bad. Which actually brings me to the first point in the video, and it's to train your eyes and gather reference that actually helps you when you're designing. Gathering strong reference might sound like something easy, but the more you progress in your design career, you'll slowly start to notice yourself finding less and less of what you're looking for, if that makes any sense. And that's because when you first start out as a designer, everything kind of looks good to you by default. And the more you understand design principles and what is considered good and what's bad, your eye starts to notice that many of the things that you're looking for in your perfect world aren't actually available online, but that's okay. This is where the term inspiration comes in strong, because most of the time you need something to base your design on. So in this tutorial, I want to design a bear Mascot logo because they always look cool in Mascot. I start by gathering reference, especially for symmetrical bears and Mascot logos. Someone that's a huge inspiration for me personally that I've learned a lot of Mascot design from is Derek from DaseDesigns on YouTube. I also reference his work because I like the way he draws aggressive creatures and really shows that emotion in the logo, and how he does the teeth and many other things. I'll link him in the description. So I found this very nice straight up picture of an angry bear, and I believe it's a great foundational piece for this logo and helps us move on to the next phase, which is sketching. This video is intended for somewhat beginners, which is why I'll be tracing this image that we have here. However, if you're naturally good at drawing, please go ahead and start sketching whatever you want. If you're wondering where you could start sketching, you could very easily print out a picture of a bear and then trace over it using a tracing paper. Currently, I'm using a drawing tablet on Photoshop. You can buy multiple cheap drawing tablets if you want to do it digitally. However, both methods are very welcome. Another very great free sketching software is Autodesk Sketchbook Pro, which has all of the layers and symmetry features that I'll be using in Photoshop. I find that having an image to draw over is a great exercise for you to develop that ability to simplify complex images to their fundamental basic shapes. In this case, the bear's most prominent features are the eyes, nose, teeth, ears, and face shape. So I'm going to start tracing this image by creating a new layer, reducing the opacity of the image below, turning on the symmetry tool, and centering it with the image, then roughly drawing out these features in the most basic form. You should always start drawing rough and detail as you go. This allows you to remain flexible and adapt early if you find mistakes in your drawing. It is important to place emphasis on the eyes because it's the most natural focal point that humans react to. Any picture you look at, you'll notice the eyes in the very beginning, so having a well-designed focal point is important to the Mascot logo as a whole. Your lines should be relatively thick and simplified. You don't have to have a lot of jagged lines in your Mascot. If you can show fur in 2 lines, then avoid showing fur in 10 lines. Anything that doesn't add much to the logo sort of ruins it if overdone. Your outer strokes should be thicker near the bottom, because naturally, humans are used to heavy bottom objects. Due to gravity, that, along with the light source coming from the top, is enough reason for you to slightly thicken the strokes near the bottom end of the Mascot. Once you're done getting the rough sketch and you're happy with it, you can start to let go of the reference and have a good look at what you've reached so far. I suggest you leave the drawing for 10 minutes or so, because when you sit on something for far too long, your eye somehow creates a perfect mental image of it, which makes you unable to notice many of the flaws. Getting back 10 minutes later, you're going to get a fresh perspective on the logo you've just drawn and start to notice that some of the things need change. Doing that over and over will reduce the error margin, and then you can start drawing with precision. This is the phase in which you let go of the rough sketch and start to make decisions. Start drawing in a single color and erasing how you want the shapes to look. Try to make the logo as clean as possible. It's extremely important to use natural curves to make the logo look visually appealing. This decision-making part comes with a lot of practice and getting to study other designers' work. Moving on to the next phase right after finalizing the sketch, the shading phase. Shading a Mascot logo gives it a lot of form and brings the whole piece to life. How I approach shading is encouraged by a lot of photography work. If you know Rembrandt lighting, you might know what I'm talking about. Either way, this all comes with a lot of practice. I plan where I want my light source to be. I only use three colors, white, gray, and dark gray. I personally like to limit myself to a few colors because limitation sparks creativity. I believe if you can deliver the same message with 2 colors instead of 10 colors, it is much more powerful. Another thing that is very respected in the Mascot logo industry is having some sort of pitch black shadow over one side of the face, which adds mystery to the whole bear. You don't need to do this, however it's a style preference and I think it looks amazing. Keep other successful Mascot logos as reference so you can dissect their shading techniques and learn from them. Okay, so you've finally finished both sketching and shading, which qualifies you for the vectorizing phase. In this phase, you take that logo that you've drawn digitally or on paper and put it on a vector program such as Adobe Illustrator and trace it again with precision to have a vector finalized logo which can be scaled to any size. The main tools that you need to know in Illustrator are the Pen Tool, Curvature Tool, Pathfinder, and Shape Builder Tool. Both the Pen Tool and the Curvature Tool are quite similar, however, I prefer to use a Pen Tool because I'm a little old school with tracing and it has a little bit more control. Using the Curvature Tool to trace something, you can click to start the path, then click over at the outmost part of the curve. Then you'll notice that it automatically applies a smooth curve. So click on the end of the curve to complete it. Now if you want to do a sharp turn, hold Alt or Option, then click on the last anchor point and you can continue the path normally. The Pen Tool is similar but the curves are done manually. Click and drag to make the curves, cancel curves by Alt-clicking. Now that you know how to use the tracing tools, it's also important to know how to cut and merge tools using the Shape Builder and Pathfinder tools. To unite two shapes together, simply make them intersect, and by selecting them both together, having the Shape Builder tool active, drag across the two shapes together by clicking and dragging, and click Unite in the Pathfinder tool. To subtract shapes, hold Alt and drag, or click Subtract in the Pathfinder tool. These are the methods that we're going to use to trace shapes and create shadows, etc. Start by drawing a line across the shape that perfectly cuts the shape in half. So you only have to draw one side of the logo and reflect it to the other side to have more symmetry. Now we can start tracing only one side of the logo. Remember to use very little amount of anchor points and use only curves where you need to. This method allows for smooth, clean lines that make the logo look professional. Trace everything starting from the outlines to the inner shapes and the shadows, then reflect all of that to the other side of the face, and start merging shapes together, and using the pen tool, start tracing the black shadow on the right side of the face to remove it from the face to show off the dark shadow. Make sure that you have all the inner shapes traced and we can finally move to the colorizing method. Now when you're coloring the logo, go for a lighter base color, darker shadow color, and a complementary saturated light color for the highlights. Knowing color theory can definitely help you tremendously. I will most probably do a video on that in the future, but a very easy way to start coloring your Mascot logos is to copy colors that work well together on other Mascot logos to get a sense of understanding why these colors work well together. To top it all off together, combine all of these shapes and make a copy, unite them all, send to back, go to Object, Path, Offset Path, and make an outline that is more or less the same thickness as a drawing, and click on OK, then give it a color of the lighter shade, which makes the logo generally stand out on darker background, and it's a nice stylistic choice in general. That's how I approach Mascot logo design, and I'm pretty sure that there are other newer ways to design them. However, these are the ways that I've learned and practiced for years. If you want to learn how to make text for Mascot logos, you'll find the video down in the description as well. I'll probably make a video on how to merge text with a Mascot logo. This logo is up for sale if you want to buy it. You'll find my business email in my YouTube About section. Now that you've made it till the end of the video, first of all, thank you for sticking around. I know this is more of a longer video. If you found it valuable, please leave a like on this video as it helps push this video out in the world for more awesome designers like you. And share this video with other people who find it useful. And don't hesitate to subscribe so you wouldn't miss out on future jam content. And let me know down in the comments which color did you like the most on the Mascot logo. and also what was new to you in this video. Do not hesitate to leave suggestions down in the comments if there is any topic that interests you. Anyway, I'll be seeing you in the next video and have a nice one.